First, part one, front of the legs. Part two, back of the legs. Guess what we're doing now? Not only are we doing the sides of the legs, we're also doing the sides of our body. So bring the foam roller. At the very edge, at the meaty side part of your hip. Top leg over. And first linger. Really adjust to make sure it's in the on the forearm, using your breath. Again, foam rolling, tiny little movements so we really get this area and linger. Foam rolling, amazingly good to release the fascia. It's like self-massage. Create oxygen and blood flow more. Release tight muscles. Release any kind of adhesion, any knot. The more you do this, the better. Here at Body Being Balance in St. Joseph, Michigan, we have foam rolling classes in person, safely, and on Zoom. We also incorporate foam rolling in our other classes. It's a great cool down and warm up. So I just went forward and back, up and down, and now I'm going to go forward, I'm going to roll forward slightly and back. So I can really get all the areas from the hip bone to the sacrum. And breathing. Oh yeah. And just linger in a part that's a little ouchy. And you can play whatever you want with your arm, top or bottom. Oh yeah. And from here, you can go down or up. I'm gonna go up. And just going, rotator cuff. Right by the armpit and kind of up and down. You can have your leg up here or whatever works for you. It's so individual to your body portions. And again, hello rotator cuff. So nice of you to say hey. And again, I can just linger. I can literally just hang out here. You can put your arm here, head, so your head's not holding too much tension, whatever works for you. And my foot is pumping to really help it move. So I'm not using any weight. It's all about body weight. I mean, I'm using body weight, but it's not like out of alignment. And lingering. And breathing. Linger. And breathing. Where is your breath? Can you release any other parts of your body? Where's your face? Can you drop it? And now, some triceps. So, kind of forward and back, forward and back. Using my breath. And lingering. Just kind of raising and lowering. So I'm raising my tricep in a tight spot. Oh yeah, and then I lower slow. And you can play with going faster, but again, it's quite efficient to go slow because it really works with all the fibers. And breathing, and let your head go as much as you could. If this is more comfortable to have it down, go for it. It's whatever does not bring tension to other parts of your body. And breathing. These triceps work so hard and really get to the top of the where is your breath? All right. So now, come back to the hip. Top leg over. Ooh, just feel that sensation. Oh yeah. And now from here, we're going to move down so you have more of my mat. Kind of just walk up. Hello, ITB. Hello. And walk down. It's like army crawl on the side. And linger. And again, if you have a tense spot, bend the leg and hang out. You can play with the foot. see what that's like. Gives a little bit more. Engaging the core. And up. And down. And up. And down. Ooh, yeah. Breathing. Where's your breath? Go a little slower. What's that like? Speed it up. What's that like? See what resonates with you. Ooh, yeah. All the way to the knee. And breathing. So now, from here, we're going to even play with our peroneals. It's a little bit more awkward, but play around. You kind of get your hip bone down. It's not a big one, but it still says oxygen and blood flow. And breathing. It's kind of just saying, hey. If you want more, you can put your other foot on it to get a little bit more pressure. Try not to sink into the shoulder. I notice myself do that. It's always a good reminder. You can do it in the mirror. I'll help you out. And breathing. All right, let's do our other side. Start at the hip. Oh yeah, and notice asymmetry. We're not the same on each side. We don't need the same things on each side. So if you're like, I only have a certain amount of time to do, and you notice which side's a little tighter, spend more time there. We don't need the same amount. Great self-massage, great lengthening muscles, releasing adhesions, creating more oxygen blood flow, yay, foam rolling. Can you go a little slower? All right, so I'm above my hip bone and my hip crease. And now I'm gonna kind of just go forward and back, forward and back, forward and back, forward, go a little slower. Yeah, and really, everybody is so unique. So just take my suggestions and play around with them and see what works best for you. Oh yeah. Where's your breath? Saw myself flop. So keep engaged. Good reminder. Alright. So now let's get the side of our body. Rotator cuff. Oh yeah. I'm just gonna linger here. Yeah. Because my knee's a little just stationary. And now I'm gonna go forward. Back, forward, the small movements. The rotator cuff has four muscles, and they're not big, but they do so much, so they need tending to. Sometimes it's hard to get them on your own. There's like gomakasana arms and massage, of course, therapeutic massage, and bonging and foam rolling are some great ways to get the rotator cuff. And breathing. And some of the posterior deltoid as well. Go a little slower, linger, and of course, you can play around. Forward and back. Forward and back. And you know, if you realize, oh, this is cool, I didn't do it on my other side, you can add it to your other side because we didn't go over the forward and back. Because for me, this is the side that needs the forward and back. But for you, maybe both sides need the forward and back. Or maybe just one. But it's really interesting how we're so asymmetrical. The forward and back goes a little deeper. Where's your breath? Linger. And now for here, I'm back. I'm going to play around with going up and down in my back position. There's so much exploration you can do. It's really magnificent. Awesome. And now, dress it. Breathing. And again, now if you need more, bring it up in certain areas. And just linger. Ah, take a nap. And breathing. Where is your breath? Can you release anywhere in your body that's holding tension? Can it let go? Can you send breath anywhere else? Can you breathe this in and release? All right. So now, scooch up. And come up the hip, I'm going to walk up, get the ITB, iliotibial band, as well as the TFL, myofascialata, which is what we did earlier. Ooh, yeah. And again, you want to linger, you've got an ouchy spot, an extra ouchy spot. Play with bending the leg, rolling the ankle. Where is your breath? All the way to the knee. Ooh, yeah, hello, darling. And breathing. And go up and down till your edge. You don't want to go past your edge. You want to go to your edge. Every day is different. Self-compassion is a huge key. And every edge for everybody is different. It's where you think. So wherever you are is perfect. All right, and so for the perennials, again, it's more, it's not huge, but it is circulation of blood flow. And you can put your leg over it to just kind of get a little bit more. And the cool thing is, like, the perennials you can reach, so you can do some self-massage and not the, I mean, you could do it on here too, but, the foam roller is super beneficial in certain areas, and this area, it's just kind of nice. It's great to tend to it, but there's other ways that you can tend to it more efficiently. Oh, thank you so much. So fun to do part three with you, part one, part two. I cannot wait for part four. Thank you so much. Please let me know if you have any questions. I am Emily. Body Brain Balance in St. Joseph, Michigan, www.bodybrainbalance.me. Stay well, stay healthy, stay safe.